फादर रिटर्निंग होम बाय दिलीप चित्रे इज प्रोबेबली द मोस्ट फेमस पोएम बाय दिस इंडियन पोएट. फ्रेंड्स, दिस पोएम कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू स्टांजास ऑफ 12 लाइन्स ईच, एंड एज यू कैन सी दिस पोएम इज रिटन इन प्री वर्स विथ नो राइम स्कीम विथ नो मीटर. द लैंग्वेज ऑफ द पोएम इज वेरी इजी सिंपल but it is full of symbolic expressions and poetic devices. You can easily understand this poem. This poem is written in first person narrative where the poet speaker narrates how his father returns home every day. So here is line by line analysis of the poem, and this analysis will help you to answer every activity that you come across. The first line, my father travels on late evening train. The poem begins with this line. The poem begins with the speaker's description of his father's traveling home. The father is traveling in a late evening train after finishing his work for the day. Late evening train indicates that his father works very long. He works very late and he returns home very late. Look at this line, second line. Standing among silent commuters in yellow light. The father is standing among the silent passengers in the yellow light inside the train compartment. This line is indicative of his sufferings during the journey. After working for the whole day, after working so hard, he returns home standing on the footboard. He doesn't get even a seat to relax. The silent commuters around him are not friendly enough to talk to him. The yellow light in the compartment, the silent commuters around him, these expressions show his monotonous life, his monotonous journey. Third line, suburbs slide past his unseeing eyes. The train speeds across, the suburbs are sliding past the moving train. But the poet's father has no intention to look at those suburbs. He has no intention to look at the scenes outside train. He is unmoved by these scenes because he has seen these scenes many a times and he does not find anything new or interesting in those scenes. The sliding landscapes also add to the monotonous life, monotonous journey of his father. His shirt pants are soggy and his black raincoat stained with mud, his bag stuffed with books is falling apart. Here, the poet makes us know that it was a rainy day. The father is traveling in a rainy day. His father's dresses are all wet with the rainwater and the black raincoat is damaged with mud. The bag he was carrying was stuffed with books and he was struggling to handle it. These lines are again indicative of the difficulties poet's father has to face during his journey. It gets even worse in the rainy season. The black raincoat indicates the lack of color in his dull life. His life is so dull. The black raincoat indicates this. Again, his bag full of books hints that he was an educated and scholarly man. But he is unimportant and he looks very ordinary, routine his journey. Next three lines. His eyes dimmed by age, fed homeward through the humid monsoon night. The poet gives us an impression of his father's age. His eyesight is dimmed by his old age. The father looks homeward with his low vision through the humid monsoon night. The gloomy atmosphere also adds to the dullness of his life. All these expressions indicate that his life is very dull, monotonous, isolated. Now I can see him getting off the train like a word dropped from a long sentence. The poet's father gets down from the train. Here, Dilip Chitre, the poet, has used a fine simile in comparing his father to an unimportant word in a long sentence. This is quite unique. He says that his father gets down just like a word dropped from a long sentence. The poet indicates how unimportant his father is to the crowd in the train. It does not really make any difference whether he got down or not. He is not that relevant to the rest of the world. Next lines. He hurries across the length of the grey platform, crosses the railway line, enters the lane. His chappals are sticky with mud, but he hurries onward. After getting off the train, the father hurries towards his home. He crosses the grey platform and the railway line and finally enters the lane. He is sticky with mud. Chappals can't prevent him hurrying onward. The poet has used the word hurries twice to bring in a sense of escapism from the dull, humid atmosphere, grey platform and muddy streets where no one would care for him. He just wants some solace at his home. He wants to run away from that rest of the world. Home again, I see him drinking weak tea, eating a stale chapati, reading a book. Here the second stanza of the poem begins. The father returns home. In this stanza, the poet depicts the isolation of his father at home. The poet sees his father reach home again, like the other days. Then he sees him drink weak tea and eat a stale chapati. The poet hints at how nobody cares for him, even at home. But the man doesn't have any complaint with his tea or food, as he is used to it. As we see, he rather concentrates on reading a book while having his tea. He has probably given up on expecting more care from his family members. He goes into the toilet to contemplate man's estrangement from a man-made world. Now, the speaker's father goes into the toilet with a thought of how men become isolated from the man-made world. And this line nearly sums up the theme of the entire poem. The father is indeed aware of his estranged situation and hopes to find some support in the family when he hurries towards his home. But the hope is diminished as he reaches and finds the same indifference there. Moreover, the toilet might act as a symbol of how small his world has been. The toilet seems to be the only place the man has to go to contemplate over his loneliness. Coming out, he trembles at the sink, the cold water running over his brown hands. The father comes out from the toilet and goes to wash his hands at the wash basin. The speaker observed him trembling at the sink when the cold water was running down his brown hands. His trembling might be due to his old age. The coldness of the water and also the fearful thought of his isolation from the rest of the world. A few droplets cling to the graying hairs on his wrist. A few drops of water clinging to the gray hairs on his wrist may have some greater implication. Water generally symbolizes life, and gray hairs stand for the old age. So, the old man's life is just holding on to his old age. This life has no significance to anyone else. His sullen children have often refused to share jokes and secrets with him. At home, the poet goes on to talk about the old man's relationship to his family members. His bad-tempered children refuse to share jokes and secrets with him. That said, they don't share a close and friendly association with their father. Rather, they regard him as an outdated, unwanted burden, though he seems to be the only earning member of the family. Next lines. He will now go to sleep, listening to the static on the radio, dreaming of his ancestors and grandchildren, thinking of nomads entering the subcontinent through a narrow pass. Now we are in the final stage of the poem, where we see the father going to sleep, listening to the radio and thinking of many things like his ancestors, his grandchildren, and of the Aryans, the people entering the Indian subcontinent through the Khyber Pass in the ancient time. The sound of the radio is even noisy, static, giving another reference to the old man's miserable life. However, his dreaming of his ancestors and grandchildren gives the impression that he finds some solace in thinking about his past and future generation. It is an attempt to escape from the present routine life that is devoid of human contact. Again, his thought of the Aryans may indicate that he is thinking of how the society has changed since the ancient times when they had come here. Now this modern world has no place for the elderly people. It has no one to think about their loneliness or care for them. Thus, the poem Father Returning Home by Dilip Chitre sympathizes with the old, neglected people in our society. No doubt, his message is well delivered here. This poem has given the poet a lot of respect and popularity through all the ages, all the years.